it's Sarah. And tonight I just wanted to share, I am still working with mixed media. Today I made a couple of mail art envelopes. excuse me. This whole thing started, the stitching of these file folders, when Robin Marie Smith, okay, I'm going to put a link to the video, actually, I'll put a link to this video, the scalloped flap mail art tutorial. It's on her blog, Creating with Stencil Girl. I'm pretty sure. I'll put that in the description box. But she, I've known about her and seen her videos before, but she did, she didn't do a tutorial for Lifebook. She just gave an interview for Lifebook and linked you to her blog and stuff. But anyway, I just tried this piece, and this is what mine turned out like. I'm not crazy about it, but I basically just tried to follow along with her, and her style of mixed media is so free and just loose. Like, to me, it doesn't seem like there's any process, or, but she definitely has a process. It's just her intuitive way of doing things. Intuitive meaning just what she thinks of, what she feels, right? So that was my attempt at that, and I'm gonna stick that in my Lifebook journal at the end of the year. But I feel like I still tend to go with Kate Crane's style. This is the Kate Crane style that I took a class with her, Journal Soup. And I feel more comfortable with her style. I don't know that I'm doing it exactly, but I'm definitely working monochromatic. Like, I'm using the same color. Anyway, if you look back at a couple of videos that I've done previously, I talked about that, okay? Then I came across, it's like lately, this week, as a matter of fact, I saw like three different people were using their sewing machines. They were doing sewing projects or fabric, okay? So the next person I want to talk about is Tiffany, and she's Southern Gals Designs. She doesn't have a lot of videos, but I'm going to put a link for her, like three different ones of hers that I really love. She doesn't have a lot of videos, but she's very good at explaining her style, which is very much like Robin's, I would say, Robin Marie Smith's. It's very similar. And a lot of collage, a lot of, she paints with her fingers. So anyway, she had a scrap of fabric that she had, like, I have this duck cloth that I got. I was going to do some Midoris and like paint them and stuff, and I never used it. So I got some out today and I was jelly printing on it. I did this one and I did a couple more, but this one just turned out so muddy. Actually, these were like twins. I did them both very similarly. And then I just did a bunch more stamping and stuff on this one because, I'm going to use it for something. I'll tell you about that in a minute. But she would just have her cloth, and she would use it, and she was cutting hearts out of it and stitching it onto her mail art. So mail art just being an envelope that you decorate and you send off with happy mail. And I've done these before. I did a swap, I think, that I participated in. I only had these yellow or orange, whatever color this is, envelopes. I did a couple of them. This one, I did a little collage on it, on the background. There's some paper back there, some book pages, some dictionary pages, and I stitched a tag on for the to and from. And I just painted it kind of like how I did my folders. I don't know why, it just seems very muddy to me, and it's not clean looking. I ended up doing this one with a file folder. So I basically just opened up one of those yellow ones and used it as a template and made myself one out of a file folder. So I like this, the coloring on this, better, because I think it just had, I don't know, I probably gessoed under it too, but this one turned out brighter. I like bright color. That's what I tend to do more. So, and then I just cut another piece of the file folder and made the to and from, and I stitched that on there too. And then, so you can open it up and then you just fold it and stitch it together. So it could be anything, and you can make yourself an envelope for mail art. And then I made this one today out of watercolor paper. So this, I happen to have like some big 11 by 14 paper. I mean, this is really stiff. It's a nice quality 140-pound watercolor paper, so it's pretty stiff, but you could still get mail in here. And it's very clean looking. I love the way this turned out. It's bright. And I didn't put any up. I was thinking of, which is something else that Tiffany does, she makes copies of her work. So see, this is a copy from my printer. I put that envelope right here, and this is a piece that I did on watercolor paper that I made. This was a cat hand video where she made an envelope. So this is another envelope that I covered with paper. It has a pocket here, and you could put what is it called when you put paper inside? A signature. So I was going to put a signature in here and use it for a little art journal or something, but I didn't, and I don't love the way it turned out. I don't know. I loved this paper. I wish I hadn't cut it up because it turned out so bright and pretty. But I was figuring out that I can look. So I made a copy of it, and then I could rip this up and use this as part of another piece of artwork. You can collage this onto a piece. And then this is just before I changed my, I had to add yellow ink and pink ink, I think, so everything turned out blue. And then this is just the other side of the envelope and the other side of this. That's just another jelly print that I had done. But I just thought, when you guys make a piece of jelly print art or a piece of art that you love, you can make a copy of it in your photocopier, your printer. Just put it in there and scan it, and then you'll have it forever, you know, even if you use up your original, you know. Well, then you can save your original and use this. So anyway, the other thing I was going to, so I just did a little bit of jelly printing today. I didn't do much. I did a folder. I did a couple of book pages, and I didn't do that one. See, this is the muddy. It just looked muddy. I did orange and purple, and just, I don't know. I didn't do much jelly printing because I was really just trying to get some color on that fabric. And here's another bigger piece of the duck cloth, and I think I'm just going to use this as a stamping off thing. So when I'm working in my working on any project, and I stamp some with a stamp, I'm just going to stamp off on here and see what I get. But this is a bigger piece of duck cloth. The other thing I was going to say, then I came across a video by Stacy, who is Pink Poodle Crafts, and she was actually, she had a big piece of duck cloth, and she just painted it with fluorescent paints. They were like tulip, which is the fabric paint, and they were sparkly. I'm going to have to look for these. She said she got them on clearance, so I mean, they may not even sell them anymore, but her whole piece was fluorescent, and then she went back in with black and white, and she was cutting it up for ATCs, or she was going to make a faux dory. So I saw that, and that's why I thought, well, I'm going to get out some fabric because I have it, and just utilize it in my mixed media. Just another thing you can use. See, this one came up pretty shimmery. I definitely used some metallic pink on that. But all right, and then the other thing that was very important that I wanted to point out was, and I don't do it all the time, I use this for my jelly printing when I brayer, you know, when you jelly print, this is what I clean my brayer on. And I have tons of pages of it. So these are just Brayer pages. But, and Cat Hand is big at this too. She absolutely stamps in here and she uses up her paint actually. Like whatever paint is left on the palette, she'll just go through here and make marks on random pages. So today I stamped on this page. This was kind of my stamping off page for when I was working on this fabric. Believe it or not, there is a yellow flower under there somewhere. There's a blue flower. I think I see a little here. The white dots, definitely. Orange. I did some orange something. I did gold dots. So this just has so much on it. These flowers are a stencil that I just stenciled on here. The black are the my foam stamp. So I didn't really like the background at all. I really basically just tried to cover it with some type of design. And so that was, I'm going to keep this out. Like I had it put away with all my jelly printing stuff. But I want to keep it out so that I can use it more often for just any mixed media spread that I'm doing to stamp off and use up paint. And that way these pages will end up being used in mixed media projects as well. And that's why I really want you guys to check out a couple of, well, you don't have to, but those of you who are interested in mixed media and this type of art journaling, Tiffany's style is so free. Just to watch her, the way she works, and she does speed up her videos, just FYI, but she talks over them and she tells you what she's doing. And it's excellent. It's very good. All right, so that was that. And then the last thing I wanted to talk about was Gina Ahrens. I don't know how you pronounce it. A-H-R-E-N-S. Gina Ahrens. She's an excellent watercolorist, great artist on YouTube. And she, I've been stitching all week, I come across a video of hers about sewing 101. And there's two different videos. One is just on the basics about sewing on a sewing machine. You know, the basic 101 information, because everyone has a different machine. You know, so get your manual out. I have a machine and I still refer back to my manual all the time. But then the second video she does is sewing 101, a simple pencil bag. Let me see, I have my iPad right here. It's called Simple Pencil Bag, Sewing 101. Yeah, and she takes you through a very simple project, and I went to Walmart tonight and I got three different zippers, and I hope these are gonna be good. I got the 9-inch, because I've never done this before, but I am totally gonna do it. Because you can always rip it out. Like you just use your thread ripper thing, and you can pull the threads out and start again. So I got pink, yellow, and green in a 9-inch polyester zipper. $1.29 they are. And I also picked up some denim needles because she said, and I don't even know if I've ever changed the needle on my machine, but I'm going to change it because I don't want to break anything. And she did recommend this for, because this is like denim. It's pretty heavy, this duck cloth. So I'm going to change that. And I think I'll put the pink zipper on this one. So let's see if that's going to, I think so. And you know what? You don't even have to, I think it's a little long. Shoot, did I? I thought I cut these. Actually, I think it's going to be fine because this stops there to there. I think I'm going to be just fine with it. And if not, I'll cut it. And you know what? I thought that I was going to be able to just fold it like this and stitch, but I'm not going to be able to put the zipper on, I need two separate pieces. I'll put the zipper on first, and then I'll just stitch around it. And the way she did it was she just left the sides raw, the raw edges, so it could fray. And I really love that. The one quilt I ever made is a rag quilt, and it has, it's like you just stack squares. There's like four square pieces of fabric stacked on top of each other, and they fray. And every time you wash it, a little bit more frays off. It's just the way it is. Because quilting, I got my machine because I was going to quilt, and quilting is too exact for me. So it kind of went out the window. So I've been loving using my machine. Don't drip in here. Go up to the bathroom. Maya's just getting out of the pool. Say hi.
Hi.
And I'm loving that I can stitch on paper. And I'm just loving that I'm using the machine again. I actually changed from white thread to black thread. You know, because I haven't done it in so long. But you just get out your manual and figure it out, and you can do it. So that's what I wanted to share today. I will share this. I'm not going to do a tutorial of how I put my zipper in, because she did it, and it's very good. She explains it perfectly. But if I do another bag and it turns out cute, maybe I'll do a tutorial. All right, you guys, so that's basically it. I just wanted to share that you could do, you can make mail art out of envelopes. You can take it apart, undo a seam, and stitch them back together. You can sew on labels. Oh, that was one other thing I was going to say. Tiffany, who I'm telling you guys, she's a talented kid. And she, like I said, she doesn't make a lot of videos, or she hasn't made, I think she's been on for maybe 2 years or something. She hasn't been on for very long, but her techniques have expanded. Like, she is so good from when she first started. She's just like boom, boom, boom. And I think she hosts like paint-ins and things, and I don't know, different things like that. So I will put those in the description box. Oh, that was what I was going to say, though. She makes tags, like stickers. She makes stickers out of her own artwork. So, like, picture this with a white section in there that you could then use as your sticker on your mail art and stuff like that. Well, you'll see. If you look through her videos, you'll see. All right, so that's it. Thanks for watching.